My daughter is going to be 10. She knows that daddy doesn't think right and he can't be trusted with some things.
I mentally separate myself in that I'm now kind of a caregiver versus a spouse. And you need
a helping. As far as the hereditary aspects of Huntington's disease is caused by a faulty gene on chromosome 4. And what that gene does is it codes for a specific protein called Huntington. And in Huntington's disease, what goes wrong with that gene is that it actually produces too much Huntington. And that's why we see the manifestation of all the symptoms that we do. That's why we see the neuronal cell death in the brain is because of all this excess Huntington. The symptoms of Huntington's disease are always manifested in a triad: cognitive symptoms, behavioral symptoms, and physical symptoms. Physical symptoms are always characteristic of Huntington's chorea. That's what the actual disease is named after, and those are the involuntary movements that we see that are classic to Huntington's disease. That's the classic symptom that we see in Huntington's disease. The involuntary movements, agitation, patients can't sit still. Behavioral manifestations of HD include aggressive behavior, depressive behavior, obsessive compulsive disorder. Some patients go on to develop psychosis, schizophrenia. In the United States, California has the highest per capita population of Huntington's disease, and Indiana is actually the second highest per capita population of Huntington's disease in the nation. Probably one of the most devastating aspects about Huntington's disease is that right now there is no cure. And not only that, there is no way to prevent the onset of symptoms. So if a patient has the Huntington's gene, they will go on to develop symptoms of HD. And from that point, it's just medical management of symptoms. We have no way of delaying that onset, nor no cure.
About 5 years ago, my friend Laura and I founded this, the StopHD group, in memory of my mother. It's important for us to do as a family because StopHD is not a really known disease, so we went through a lot with my mother, and when I was a child, there wasn't a whole lot out there that, you know, for support.
My husband had been diagnosed, and we just needed some support, and the more support groups that I went to, the more knowledge that I had about HD, the more I wanted to do something about it. It was a way for me to get control over my life again. So the deeper I got into it, the more settled I became with HD. So I met the Stop HD ladies, and each year I do a little bit more.
We do multiple events throughout the year. Started with our first walk in 2005, and we just did our fifth walk, as you can tell by the shirts that we're wearing. We've done three classic car shows called Cool Cars for a Cure. We've done two cornhole tournaments now, cornhole, and two ladies shopping events. Lord, I'll be there,
yes, I will. I found out about Huntington's disease back in 1999. I got a phone call from my birth mother. I was adopted, so I didn't know anything about Huntington's disease. And I got a phone call from my birth mother stating that my birth father was diagnosed with Huntington's disease, and I decided to go ahead and get the blood test. So I got my diagnosis back in January of 1999. So I've actually known for 10 years.
It has affected our family in every way possible. From our finances to our emotional connection to the connection we have with friends and family. And trouble,
and you need a helping hand. He's amazing. He was an angel sent from heaven because he handled it. I mean, it's horrible. It's horrible to go through. I can't even describe it. But he was
amazing through the whole process, really. Be there
to brighten up even your darkest nights.
It isn't the same thing. You don't have the daily sitting on the couch together. You don't have the conversations. He doesn't converse like we used to. It's more of a question, and he'll answer yes or no.
I'm here for my grandma because she's lived with it for as long as my great-great-grandpa has been alive.
All you gotta do is go.
I didn't grow up with it, so I had no idea what it was like or what it was about. Because I didn't have a mother or father who were sick like a lot of people had. So I never learned about the disease. So it was overwhelming and felt very unreal.
If the sky above, it has strained his family, his siblings from us, because once he was diagnosed, they became at risk.
Nancy lived with the disease and worked until 1986. She retired from work in 1986, and then she stayed with us at home until 1992, and then she was put in a extended care facility in 1992 and passed away in 1998.
Here today to support this group because, first of all, it's very worthwhile. Secondly, there's Huntington's in my family. I have it. My son has it. My daughter does not, thank God. This is the first year I've walked, and I'm just glad that I was physically able to do it.
I started seeing symptoms in the fall of 2006, so about 3 years ago. And I just have early signs, so I just have early symptoms. So I basically have some twitches in my feet and a little bit of memory loss.
People can be so cold. They'll hurt you and desert you. Well, they'll take your soul if you let them.
We are StopHD.